Hello friends, today we will see the third topic, that is the unit number 3 from the information theory and source coding. The name of third unit, it is the unit 3, and the name of it as a cyclic codes. Cyclic codes. Okay, in this This is nothing but in previous chapter we have discussed about the linear block codes. We have discussed about the linear block codes. In the linear block codes, as we are having a block structure which contains the message bit as well as the parent bit, that is also called as the redundant bits. That's why that block structure is nothing but a linear block code. Now, in this unit, as a cyclic code, this cyclic code, it is nothing but a subclass of the linear block code. Okay? This cyclic codes are nothing but, it is a subclass of the linear block code. Remember that it is a subtype of the linear block code. Now, in the cyclic codes, we are having which are the properties of the cyclic codes. Okay. Properties of the cyclic codes. As we know the linear block codes, we must know what is the property of linear block code. As its name indicates, linear block code, it is nothing but a linearity. This linearity property which must satisfied by the cyclic code. Okay, what is this linearity property? That means whatever the cyclic codes are there, they should all have to satisfy the all the properties which belongs to the linear block code, as well as this linearity property. This linearity property, that is nothing but when we add two linear block codes, at that time the new addition of that two or the sum of the two linear block codes are nothing but a new valid code. New valid code. When it generates the new valid code by the summation of the two linear block codes, at that time that is called as the linearity property. When it's satisfied by the cyclic code, then and then only we say that that particular code is nothing but a cyclic code. As well as another second property for this cyclic code, it is nothing but a, which is we say that we are having a two property for this cyclic codes. Okay, now we have seen the linearity property from the linear block code. Also, the another requirement to satisfy the cyclic code, as the second property, it is called as the cyclic property. Cyclic property. This cyclic property, it is nothing but a, when we shift that code in any direction, at that time whatever the generation of the new code, it will be a valid code, and then only we say that that particular code, it is nothing but a cyclic code. And this cyclic property we can implement in the cyclic code by using the shift registers. Shift registers. As we know, the shift registers, already we have discussed shift register, we have seen in the digital electronics in the second year. That's why we know the shift register. Shift register, it is nothing but a, it is a combination of the flip-flops. Depending upon the combinations, we say that the shift registers, that is, and as its name indicates, it is a shift registers. That means there is a shifting procedure. We can shift one bit either in the rotation, either in the right direction or in the left direction. That means whatever the bit contains, it will shift in this direction, that is a right shift. By using the shift registers, we can satisfy or we can implement the cyclic codes to verify the cyclic property. So encoding and the decoding process will be validated for this cyclic code. We are using a Galois field. And this Galois field, it is nothing but we are having an algorithm for that. By using that, we can encode the cyclic codes, encoding and the decoding. This encoding of the cyclic code by using the Galois field or Galois algorithm, it is very much easy for the encoding, and the decoding, it is also very efficient method. That's why we can say that in the Galois field, by using the Galois field, we say that the encoding and the decoding of the cyclic codes will must verify, and it is very much simple to recreate the cyclic codes. Now, in the exam paper, they have asked many times as define the cyclic codes, which are the properties should be satisfied by the cyclic code. That is nothing but what are the requirements of the cyclic code. So first we will see the detailed definition of the cyclic code, and then we will go for the properties of the cyclic code. Now we see the actual detailed definition of the cyclic code, because there was a question asked by the Unipune as what is the cyclic codes, which are the cyclic codes, and which are the basic requirements for the cyclic code. This question was asked in May 2016 for the 7 marks. So that's why we will see this topic neatly as definition of the cyclic code. Cyclic code, it may be defined as if they satisfy the following properties or the following conditions, as they have to, as it is a linear code, and if it satisfies cyclic property. Okay, when you satisfy both the conditions, as if it is a linear code and if it satisfies the cyclic property, then we say that code, it is nothing but a cyclic code. Okay, that is regarding the cyclic code. Now next we will see the properties of the cyclic code. As properties, we are having the first property, it is a linearity property. As we know, the linearity property, that means when there is a sum of any two numbers gives a valid new code word, then that new code and that code word is nothing but a linear code word, or which satisfies the linearity property. That means we must remember that the sum of any two numbers gives a valid new code word, then it is called as the linearity property. Okay, and the second property, it is nothing but a cyclic property. Cyclic property, it is nothing but when we shift a new code word. A code is said to be cyclic if any cyclic shift of a code word results in the formation of another valid code word. Then whatever the new generated code is nothing but a new code word. There should be a generation of the new code word. When we shift it by 1 or by 2, when that time whatever the new code word is there, that is nothing but a cyclic property. That at that time only we say that the cyclic property, it is a satisfied by the cyclic code. These are the two important properties of the cyclic codes. Now we will see how we can shift the code word by using the shift registers. For example, we will take one numerical regarding this cyclic code, regarding the shifting of the new code word. And we consider one code for this 0, x1, x2, up to the xn minus 1. And this is the which contains in the code structure. Okay. Now, this is called as the original code word. It is called as the original code word. Okay. Now, in next step, what we have to do as we have to do a shift by 1 bit. Here we have to do shift by 1 bit or 1 digit. That is nothing but this xn minus 1. It is shifted towards the this side. That is the right shift is here. That's why xn minus 1 comma x0 comma x1, and this is a x2. Okay, it is a shifted. This xn minus 1 is shifted to the right. This x2 comes here, x1 comes here, x0 comes here. In this way, there is only a shift by 1. That is called as the x. It is called as xn minus 2. Now again, we have to shift it by 1. Shift by 1 bit or 1 digit. And here, a shifting by 1 bit, that is nothing but a x0, x1, xn minus 3. Here it will come xn minus 2. That's why here it comes xn minus 3. In this way, it is shifted like this. x1, x0, xn minus 1, xn minus 2. Because it is shifted 1 by 1. Then, in the next right shift, there is a shifting again. That means there is a shifting by 1, only 1 digit. In this way, shifted code words are new code words. New code word, as it comes in this way, as x1, x2, x3. In this way, whatever the generated code words are the new code word. This is also new code word. This is also new code word. This is also new code word. When there is any repetition is there. Okay, that's why all these are new code words. When this property is satisfied by the code word, by the generation of the new valid code word, then we say that there is a cyclic property. It is a satisfied by the cyclic code. This is regarding the shift register by the right shift by only 1 digit. Now we will see another numerical or the example to clear your concept regarding the cyclic code by using the binary cyclic number. First we will see one example regarding the binary cyclic number. Okay. We'll take one example for this. Check if the following codes are cyclic or not. They have given a code x1 is equal to code x1 is equal to 0000, comma 0101, comma 1010, comma 1111. Okay, this is the first code word. And the second code word, code x2 is equal to 0000, 0110, 1001, and 1111. Okay, just we have to check as these code words are cyclic or not. So first we will take the check code x1. Code x1. Okay, first we will take the code x1. Among that, first we will take this 0000 by using the cyclic property. Consider the first code. The first code word is zero 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 zero. Now take this in the shift register as 0000 is there. When we shift by 1, what will happen? By the right direction as this 0 will be shifted by the right. That's why 0 comes here as it is, 0 will be there. There is already this 000 in the code word. That means it is nothing but a valid code word. This code word is already there in X1. Now consider the second code word is 0101. Now consider second code word as 0101. Now put this in the shift register. When we shift it by 1, what will happen? This 1 comes here. And all digits are shifted by the 1. As 1 comes here, 1010. Already this 1010 are in the code word. Okay, that's why we satisfy the new cyclic property. Now we will take this 1010 code word. As we have taken 1010 is there, now shift it by 1. Okay, which generates the new code word. That is nothing but a by shifting. What will happen? This 0 comes here. 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1. This 0, 1, 0, 1 already in the code word. In this same manner, when we shift this 1, 1, 1, we will generate again this code word. That means all the code words are satisfied the cyclic property. That's why this is a valid cyclic code. Okay, that's why we have considered this code x1. Now we will see this regarding the code x2. First we will see this 00 already we have seen. Now take this 0110. When we shift it by 1, what will happen? This 0 comes here, again 0, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1 is there, 0, 0, 1, 1, it is not in this code word. That's why this code word is not satisfied the cyclic property. Now take this number as 1001, then we shift it by 1, okay, at that time what will happen, as we are having a new code word. This 1 will come here as 1100. Is there 1100 in this one? No. That's why this code word is not satisfying the cyclic property. Okay? And this code word will satisfy the cyclic property. That means code x1, it is a valid cyclic code. And this code x2, it is not a valid cyclic code. In this way, we can clear the concept regarding the what actually the cyclic code, how we can satisfy the linearity property as well as the cyclic property. Okay, so today we will stop here.